I suspect the first 10 minutes of this game will be very important as each team jostles for position, try to take control of the game. It'll be interesting to see how it plays out.
Kai Emil getting himself involved. He's not been a major factor for St. Lucia throughout this tournament. Number 21.
Hill with a fairly comfortable margin. It is not easy to score 5 goals against Viewfort. Oh, and a nice shot and a goal. It's in the back of the net. It's exactly what we expected from Bishon Richards. We just spoke about what this young man can do at that range, both from dead ball, and he asserts his authority on this game.
Phenomenal, the young attacking midfielder for the Vincy Ballers, as the ball comes in and he's dealt
with. It's a wrestling match. And that man, Shemron Phillips, Shaba, as they call him, there to take. We've seen how calm and comfortable he is on the ball. A true number 10, as his jersey indicates. This Vincy team, you get the feeling that they play a lot of football together. They never seem pressured. They play with a certain calm, like they're in the park on a Sunday. They see her breaking it up. Oh, and here's a chance. Oh, Morgan putting his frame and receiving hugs all around Morgan.
Most certainly have been, even Steven.
Oh, and it's always on the goal line, and goal line chaos. Couple nervous moments. One of the first times I've seen the Vincy defense in a bit of chaos. Whop and over, and it hits the outside of the nervous moment. You cannot trust the ball at the feet of this man. He has been practicing this. You know, I could imagine Bishon Richards with the 2 bags of balls down in the park field on a Saturday from 6 a.m. practicing those dead balls.
Wilfred with the ball at his feet.
Morgan sliding in.
Jovel Morgan.
Vincy Ballers, who are leading 2-1. Goals coming in the first half. All goals coming in the first half. First by Bishon Richards, and then Bascom.
Nice bit of skill there, attempted skill by Stephen Pierre.
Yeah, and then we see Keegan Cole tying it, well, not tying it up, getting the first goal for the only goal for St. Lucia Select 11 just before the stroke of halftime. Shaba always confident, a little too confident. And that's what makes him special, I think, Shaba. He does not feel pressure. And the crowd likes it. You see, we heard the crowd go off.
Ooh.
It's exactly what they came to see, huh? I think Braville has done well on this wing. Oh, there we see Bishon Richards. This man, Bishon Richards, being very tricky and scoring his second goal. Bishon Richards. Look at what it means here as the Vincy Ballers see their wonder boy. From day one, he has shown that he is a cut above. He just glides through the middle, very two-footed player, and he calmly slots away past the keeper, Donai. There wasn't much he could do about it. He stayed very calm, and Bishon Richards scoring what is this now his 7th goal in the tournament. As a midfielder, it means a lot, right, to be the second highest scorer.
The pride of Hope International FC over in Trinidad, St. Vincent and the Grenadines.
No doubt they're cheering. No doubt they're looking on and cheering at this this young prospect,
a youth international for SVG.
I'm sure, Terry, we'll see a lot of this young man in the future at senior club and country level. I have to admit, I did not, this is one team, I mean, not as familiar with football in the St. Vincent and the Grenadines. I did not expect this level of grace and composure from these boys coming out here against what I thought was solid talent.
Well, they normally wear Brazilian colors, so...
Well, you can tell in the style that they play. Yeah, this is when Bascom, strong with this back to the goal.
Daniel takes this one, there's still danger. Team St. Lucia.
The referee stopped for a moment and he calls the penalty.
For Team St. Lucia, it's going to be Keegan Paul against Josh Stowe for the opportunity to make this a one goal gap once again.
Let's see what he can do, Keegan Paul. Oh my, Keegan Cole, over the bar.
Cole goes for six. The Vincentians are jubilant.
Because there aren't many Vincentians here. A nice run from Pierre. There's still a lot of time to go here in the second half of the finals. Now this man, Bishon Richards, taking them to the corner. Oh my goodness. But there is that battle we spoke about between Felician and Bascom. Oh, it's not this time, Braville says. Not this time. Alexander. Oh, a nice ball over the top.
Danger for Vincy Ballers. Still there. Juan Adams comes in, number 15.
Adams has added value in the games that he's played before. Solid player. Oh, nice touch by Bishon Richards.
So this is the final of the 2022 Free Kick Youth Cup. Certainly living up to its billing. It's been a very good game, very crafty game by both teams. We've seen some great skill by St. Vincent and the Grenadines, but here comes St. Lucia. On the attack, it's Keegan Paul.
A little long, is he going to get it?
Wilfred was making a very willing run down that left flank.
A little too long.
On the attack are St. Vincent and the Grenadines, but Shimron Phillips is brought down, 17 years old.
Well, Shimron is only 17. Wow. So we may be seeing him in this tournament again next year.
Absolutely.
If not playing professional football somewhere out there or at a university in North America. And now there's a breakaway. Mackay. No, very patient, this fella Morgan. Look at him. How are you going to get her wrong? How are you going to get her? It's like a wrestling match over there, Morgan.
And he ends up putting it out anyway.
Morgan is just keeping him at bay, almost toying with him, it felt like. So despite being 3-1 up, this Vincy team has not eased back at all. They continue to attack. At no point they started to play conservatively or defensively in any way. Almost like they came not just to win, but to show the brand of football. It's a promotion for the Vincy brand of football, it looks like. I understood that this Vincy Baller team arrived here on a catamaran. Took them 8 or 10 hours to get here. Probably had a lot of time to bond before the tournament.
We've left Kingstown. Made it over here on Tuesday evening.
Mm-hmm.
After some of the teams had already played their first game on Wednesday.
Yeah, they were the last team to arrive.
Goalless draw.
So I guess it's apt that they finish us off here. Last to arrive, last to leave. But it is this man today who is the hero for Vincy Ballers.
He done the job.
Playing from the midfield, scoring the second most goals in the tournament with his two goals today. One, here's an attack. A through ball, but it is going to go past Pierre. At this point in Champions League, they would now be etching the name of Vincy Ballers if we were Champions League on the trophy. There would be a guy in the back room beginning to etch.
Fancy and Mesopotamia. Might do a tour of St. Vincent and the Grenadines upon their return. Just two is ready to pick up the trophy. Put down the ball and pick up the trophy.
And that's it. That is it. St. Vincent and the Grenadines watching on here should be very proud of this team.
Mike Mercy Oliver, Keith Joseph,
Vincy Ballers,
Pamanos Ballantyne, perhaps even the Prime Minister.
Look at them. This is what it means to them. 10-hour ride via sea to get here, and now the challenge trophy of the 2022 Free Kick Youth Cup in St. Lucia will be going back on that catamaran for a 10-hour trip as it makes its way back to St. Vincent and the Grenadines. This Vincy team, you get the feeling that they play a lot of football together. They never seem pressured. They play with a certain calm, like they're in the park on a Sunday. And being not as familiar with football in the St. Vincent and the Grenadines, I did not expect this level of grace and composure from these boys. Coming out here against what I thought was solid talent.
Well, they normally wear Brazilian colors, so...
Well, you can tell in the style that they play.